Welcome back, everybody. And welcome to all the new people. Getting close to 50. I said I would release World on 50 subscribers, so that's not too far away now. So today, I haven't had any explosions yet, which is a good thing. So I was thinking about finishing off the build-up here, which was to automate placing the uranium rods inside here. So I'd like to replace the uranium cells when they're spent to keep the nuclear reactor running all the time. And I'm going to do that with a bit of buildcraft and red power. Actually, not buildcraft, it's going to be a little bit more of the logistics piping. Okay, so I've started to make a little tunnel down here. So we're going to bring our uranium rods up in standard tubing. That's a handy way to do it. Okay, I need to replace that pipe there with one of these. And I probably need that pipe back because I'm running low. I could make some more. So that was just because there's a junction there now. And what's the best way to do this? So I will need to make some more. One more. I've only got this here so that I can, if need to be, put more logistics pipe up there. If you remember, the logistics pipe out to the farm needed a couple of extenders on it. You can see one of them just there to make the distance all the way from my base all the way out to the farm. So I'll get on with that and I'll be back with you shortly.
Hello guys, I'm just making a few things off camera, so a little reminder on the solar panels. We're going to need a few of these. I'm going to make four of them. So blue alloy ingot is silver and nickelite in one of these alloy furnaces. I must say, creating all the items for the red power stuff now is becoming less interesting as I expand automated crafting, and I think that's my next project. I'm going to have to get a way to automate all the bits and pieces that come out of red power. So the silicon wafer is you have to put sand and coal inside the alloy furnace, and you get a silicon boule, and then you can chop that up with a diamond handsaw to get silicon wafers, and that's used in creating the filters. You've seen that before. Okay, so there's a new item. Oh. Yeah, and the blued up wafers, just nickelite with that silicon wafers. Now, the new item we need is called, I can't remember. Retriever. Bit of an odd looking recipe. It uses a filter in it. Now the retriever does something a little bit more than what the filter does. Now the filter can work on adjacent inventory spaces, as we saw in the last episode, where we were using it to retrieve empty water buckets and then getting them filled up in that system. Well, the retriever can pull and retrieve items from anywhere connected to the pneumatic tubes, which are to do with red power. So it doesn't have to be an adjacent imagery space, it can request a pull from some other device. And it's the retriever that we need the solar panels and the battery box for because it uses electricity. It uses the red power electricity. Okay, let's see if we can get this. Can't remember. That's not going to be right, is it? No. Oh, blue alloy ingot. No. It's brass. Ah, okay, not gold. Okay, for brass, we need bit of copper and tin, I think. It's all these bits and pieces that need to go into this. Let's take one tin in there. Well, let's just get it to go for one cycle, so we'll have a few of them. Yeah, so bits and pieces like that that want me to set up a automated crafting for red power. Okay, there's a retriever. So we've got a retriever, a filter, some more pipes. Got a supply logistic pipe because we're going to want to feed a chest upstairs. And the last thing I want is a battery box. And this is the red power battery box, of course. And I probably don't have any wood. I've also expanded up here. System can now start to make some of that stuff. And we do want a timer. And we're up to pa 3 pages. Woohoo! Is that a timer? Nope. It's a timer. And we need a bit of wood. For the timer to work, over this side I've had to set up this, so there's a new induction furnace here creating them. Okay, while we wait for that, do I need more iron? Is it? Yeah. Plenty of pneumatic tubes as well. Now we could do with some of the bluetricity wire as a timer. Okay, I'm probably gonna have to hunt my base for that. Blue alloy wire. Only one. Let's have a look in here. This is getting to become my dreaded bag with just about everything unmanageable inside it. Right, I don't see any. I think I need more more blue alloy ingots. can't quite remember the recipe for this, but it should be something like that. Where's my wool? Did I put that away? Yeah. Just get some normal wool. Okay. Right, I think we've got everything we need. Daytime? No. Of course it isn't. Okay, so we're going to go straight upstairs and try to fit this into the system. Ah, we don't have everything we need. There's a reason why all these water bottles are here. Don't know if anybody spotted those. The reason for these is they're going to be not used for cooling the nuclear reactor, but as placeholders within the nuclear reactor, because we're going to be wanting to push into the nuclear reactor the nuclear rods, what do you call them, uranium cells. Of course we don't want empty inventory slots for them to be able to go into, so that's why we've got the extra.
Woo.
So you can see our uranium cells are depleting now, or getting towards depleted. So these are just going in around the system to, so that when our filter tries to push nuclear rods in, it won't be able to find empty inventory slots apart from where the nuclear rods are taken from. And they need another. Right, I'm going to get that done. Okay, so that's that done. These haven't been used for anything other than placeholding. Remember I was saying that that was an extra coolant cell? That will replace one of these blocks of water, and we're going to need it to. So for this side, I'm going to knock that out. And the block of water beside the nuclear reactor there will no longer be, well, it'll be replaced by pneumatic tubes. So let's get that done first. What I'm interested to see is, well, I want to keep an eye on the nuclear reactor temperature, make sure it's fine while we're working up here. These depleting any further. It should be okay. Chest just here. Oh, actually, no way. this chest to go. There. Okay, supply logistic pipe. Let's connect that up. And for this one, we want it to keep stocked 3 uranium cells. Ah, no. This is red, which means it's not able to communicate all the way down the pipe system. Which means we need to knock out one of these and replace it with a basic logistics pipe. Ah, no. What's going on down here? That's all it is. Ah, there we go. Perfect. Okay, to pull out of the chest, we're going to be using a filter. And to push back into the chest, we're going to be using the retriever. The retriever will be able to connect up to the system and say, hey, give me depleted uranium cells eventually. Okay, next up, may as well just have the battery box beside that, so we didn't need the wire at all, maybe. Is this the best design? I'm just thinking I'm going to need more of these pneumatic tubes if I do it this way. More than I have on me. Just need one more. For here. Right, I'll go and get on with that. So we thankfully overmade the brass ingots, but that's what's used for the pneumatic tubes as a reminder. Okay, let's get back up. So we have power coming into there, that's fine. And we can see that this is powered now. So we need to tell the filter it's only interested in uranium cells. And we need to tell this it's only interested in a particular item that I don't have yet. And that is a depleted uranium cell. So we'll have to wait for those to finish off. So I shall be back with you soon. Alright guys, we're going to look at something else now. This is an EU reader. What I want to know is how much power are we bringing into the system, and can it be used to completely power all my devices? And I've had to sleep there because we want to see how much power is coming in from the solar panels. So I want to be able to keep these running hot, and these. That's going to mean when I make a request for an item out there, the machines are going to be at top capacity rather than having to warm up. Now, each of the induction furnaces, they need 1 EU per tick to keep them hot. Each of these devices here, however, need 3 EU per tick to keep them running. So in total that is 30 EU per tick. I've got 6 induction furnaces requiring 1 tick per each, and then we have 8 3 EU per tick devices down here. So that's the singularity compressor, the rotary macerator, the centrifuge extractor. Okay, now this EU reader is going to help me determine how much energy is coming into the system. So this line here should be how much is coming in from the solar panels. So it's just got nothing to do, so maybe it isn't drawing any. Well, how about we power them up and then see. This one's up from the nuclear reactor. Yeah, there's zero coming in. Well, let's power them on and then see. Okay, so we can attach it directly to these. When it does come around the back, so now they're working away, keeping the heat up. So 8, and I was expecting 6. Well, that's hardly an accurate measurement, is it? That might be getting closer. Longer average time. Yeah, around about 6 EU per tick to keep these running on full. Okay, now that they're running on, now that we're drawing power, let's see if we can see something coming into the system. Okay, so that's bringing in power. Right, let's do a longer measurement. This keeps going up, that's amazing. So the other way to measure this would be how many solar panels do we have outside? It's 15.71. I'm expecting that number to be a lot higher. Well, that was a very short measurement. Okay, yeah. Again, I think it might be suffering from the fact that let's just try and get all those on as well. I'm expecting this one to be 3 per tick. This is according to the wiki, of course, so it should be about 24 it's using up here. So that's, check that out now. Yeah, it should be about 6 on that side and 24 on that side. Yeah, so the 6 there. Gotta be patient when we're doing these measurements. 8 EU per tick, so that could almost be using 1 EU per tick to keep these running hot, and maybe the wiki's wrong on that. Because that isn't near 24, although. Although it possibly was working on some items. And if it was working on some items, then it would have been using a little bit more power. That's maybe why we've seen different numbers coming through. Okay, anyway, now that we've got all that up and running, let's see. I'm expecting this number to be quite a bit higher, and it might be just that because we're getting power. Maybe it's only drawn what it needs. Because our power level's on full. Maybe it's all fine. Maybe I shouldn't worry about it. I was wanting to do the calculation just to make sure that we could keep them on hot all the time. Must be manually doing those at some point. Getting close to being used up. So as long as this number keeps going up, we aren't drawing more than we're generating. So not sure what happens when this completely fills up. So we're getting 70 EU per tick up here. That's only going to show us a signal if there's something to do down below, so not really going to tell us much. Ah, no, didn't really have a look. Yeah, it all seems to be still cooled, despite the fact that we've got that tubing going in there now. While I'm up here, let's have a look at the redstone that needs to be done. So I think what we'll do is we'll just bring it out this way. Stick a timer down with a switch, of course, so it doesn't annoy us if we need to switch it off. Okay, so that should be pretty much it for this build up here. So just need to wait to get hold of a depleted uranium, so put it in there and then we can fire it up and see what happens. Okay, I'll be back with you when that's ready. Well, welcome back, guys. My nuclear reactor finished its cycle and the uranium has all gone. Now, there's a chance that you will get
one of these near depleted uranium cell when the cycle finishes. If you get one of those, and that's what I was waiting for, but I didn't get one this time, that's what needs to go in this retriever, a near depleted uranium cell. So until I do get one of those, I'm going to just knock that wire off, because I don't want anything, I don't want everything coming out of the system. You know, you do want to make sure you have a near depleted uranium cell mentioned in here. That's odd, how did that get in there? Oh well. Okay, so we should be able to just switch it on. So there's the three uranium cells going in. There's three more coming in to place in the chest. Now occasionally what you'll see here is only two uranium cells, and that's because one of them is figuring out if there's an inventory or an adjacent inventory in that system. Anyway, uranium cells have gone in the right place. So the only other thing to do to this is when you check your nuclear reactor, and if you do see one of these near depleted uranium cells, place it in here and then reconnect the redstone wire over here, and it'll be fully automated and remove any byproducts from the system if they are created. But this will keep it topped up nicely. Okay, well, we'll say good Minecraft evening to you all, and I shall see you next time.